What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my studio. I'm Joseph Finchum, you are you, and, well, this stream is going to start off with a lecture. Not really. Okay, anyway. I guess this goes into the theory of I guess this goes under the category of color theory. You know, people often say, paint what you see, not what you think you see. And my chat is not moving. Let's refresh the chat. There we go. Bonus ASMR? What was that? I'm hoping I'm on camera. Hi, Clark. How you doing? Okay, so, in the reference photo that I have, and I'm going to put that up now, hopefully. In the reference photo, if you look at the part, that's the water reflecting the sky. What you think you see, what your mind tells you is that that is brown soil, dirt, with a blue haze over it reflecting on the clear water. So your initial thought is I should paint it brown and then put blue over it. And if you do that, you're going to get a really dark brown. This color is not brown. I have a breakdown of the colors. Hopefully this is coming up on the screen right now. And you can see that I have some dots off on that side of the photo. And the color there is more, it's like a slate purple, slate blue into the purplish range. So that's what we're actually going to start with. That's what we're going to try and mix. I have some colors here. I have not even started putting them out on my palette yet. I don't use a wet palette. This is a picture frame. It's a piece of glass. It works great. Scrapes off easily. So, got a little bit of purple. Probably going to need a little bit more. A little bit of gray. Some white. I'm using Liquitex Basics. I like the small tubes, they're easy to hold. A little black. The black is a little creamy, a little too creamy. Some water here. Get this brush wet. I'm using a fairly large filbert that's all roughed up. And I'm mixing some gray and white. I wanted to do a palette cam, but my system can't handle it. So my water is going to start around here. And I'm just gonna try and rough this in. I don't really care about not going where the rocks will be, because the rocks are going to be over the entire thing. So I will block those in later, and we'll see what happens. This may end up being a little squished in the end, because, you know, the picture is a little bit wider than my canvas is. I tried to get it, crop it to about the same size, but it's not perfect. I don't care about brush strokes. I'm just trying to get some paint on the canvas. I need much more paint. And this is a little too, I don't know how it's coming out there, but it's a little, it looks a little too purple. It needs probably a little bit of blue. Let's see if I can tone it down with some black. There's a cloud reflecting up here, so I'm leaving that part open. Should go back to the regular reference photo. I had a few problems earlier with OBS changing the size and shape of my windows here. So hopefully everything is working right this time. I'm just trying to make sure I work this paint really well into the tooth of the paper. Paper canvas. This is canvas. My first three live streams were all color pencil drawing, so. And I chose this painting because I've kind of been sitting on this image since 2013 when I went on a hiking trip in late fall. Or early fall? I don't know. It was a long time ago. And I'm very okay with my values changing in different spots, because there are things in the reference photo on the bottom of the water you know, the bottom of the creek bed. You know, things that shine through that you can tell, little rocks and stuff. Oh, and my buddy's here already, huh? Okay, so now I'm just going to tone this down a bit. I'm going to take the same color. I'll just give it some. Indication of little things under there. You know, happy little rocks and trees and blah, blah, blah. I'll probably come back through and add a little bit more stuff in here later on. Yeah, this is all for play. Nick. Today is blizzard season. I don't know how it is up there in the North Pole, but this is what I got going on out here. We got about 9 inches on the ground right now. I know, in the North Pole, that's not a lot, but... needs to be a little darker. Little spots there. Okay. Let me rinse this off a bit. Okay, so I'm going to put a little gray here just so I can block in some of this cloud area here. I'm going to lighten this up. I'm switching to a smaller brush. There is a little bit of actual blue shining through, so I'm gonna leave that there. Man, I'm just being scruffy with this because this is all just blocking in. I'm just getting some shading in here. I'm going, basically, what I'm putting down is midtones. I'm starting with all of my midtones. That's how I've always painted. So, that's what I'm doing. Okay. So, now, I do have a pencil here, and I'm going to block in. There's a log on the left side, which goes to about, say, here. That's a... It goes all the way up. That's what's actually... The log is actually what's causing the ripples. I was sitting at this spot having a snack, and other people were coming by on the hike. And every time someone would step on this log, this one little part of the log sticking off, like a little broken off branch part, would hit, tap the water, and it would ripple outwards. Ooh, Clark, that's deep. Deep, deep snow. Okay, I have a little bit of ground over here. And then, you know, gotta have some of my rocks. Just gotta know where I want them to be. In there. Maybe one up here. This is a water-soluble pencil. So hopefully these will all blend in pretty well. But I'm just making, you know, basic shapes where I want stuff to be. Little indications so I know for later. I'm not following the reference pretty much at all. You know, I know what I want to do. And I want to make the colors right. And I want to catch the feel of it. But I don't really care where everything goes, per se. A little bit more of this purplish color up, and a little more purple. Just get into some of these spots. Creating just a little bit more shading in some spots. That is deep. With how cold it is outside, I'm kind of surprised that my paint is drying so fast. But it's kind of warm in here. Okay, rinse this off. Okay, how are we doing here? I'm gonna let this dry a little bit. Am I being stabby? I do have a blow dryer, but I don't think I really need that just yet. Thanks, NH Chicky. It is a good mug. I got it at Disney. I also have this one, but this one is for paint water. Okay. Now, I'm going to use a tool here that some of you probably don't have. This is a thumbtack with a piece of string attached to it. And this is going to give me some guidelines. All I'm going to do is I'm not putting the thumbtack into the canvas. I'm using the flat end of it. See, I'm using the flat end. I'm taking my pencil. I wrap it around. I hold the string in my hand. Come over here. I'm not holding it tight enough. I'm going to do one extra loop. Can you tell I'm nervous? Okay. Put the flat part against the canvas. There we go. Now I have some guidelines for my ripples. So, where are we going to begin here? Probably that's a trade secret. That's a trade secret, Nick. Damn. Linguistics be difficult. So, probably going to start with some of the green up in the top area over here next to the cloud. And while it is a green, there's a lot of olive drab and brown in there. You know, the eye says green. But the color swatches, they don't say green. This is probably a little too green. What do you want? Go away. Go, go. Sorry, cat problems. Animal owners understand. I think I mentioned I chose this painting because it's kind of abstracty. I don't have to be super, super realistic or really great with my, areas of detail. I'm probably only going to get the blocking done in this session, but hey, I'm going to try. I am burning through my paint. As I'm going, I'm trying to variate. I'm trying to get some variation in the colors for the blocking in, which will make it a little bit better in the long run. And as I go over it, I'm getting rid of some of my brush strokes from the last, you know, layer that I did. This comes out a little bit more. Okay. Think I want a little bit more brown right up in this area. I have a big bucket of water to get the initial paint off. Then I go to my little cup. Scrub it on a paper towel. Okay, we're gonna start getting into some orange here. It's not a bright orange. I mean, it is a bright orange, but I will be toning it down a bit. Could use a spritz of some water here. Okay. Thinned a lot. That little bugger. He doesn't do this a lot, which is funny. It's only when I'm in here. I don't know why. He tried to eat my paintbrush. I'm clearly kind of changing the shape of this tree. Like I said, the reference is, it's there, but it's not the most important thing that I'm looking at. I'm looking at the color and what I want to bring to it, you know, artistic interpretation, as they say. High caution, Shana. Shana? Shana. Which one? Flattening out some of these brush strokes. Just knocking them down. Okay, now we're going to go into a little bit more yellow. Yellow's going to be more right here. Leaving that orange there, you know, on the brush so that it blends. Not being neat at all. Who needs to be neat? And sometimes when I load the brush, I'm picking up some of that orange that I had left aside. Kind of working it in too. Yellow is extremely transparent and is not going to go over this graphite well, so I'll have to work a few layers over this, try and get that blended out more. I don't think you can see the actual pencil lines. They might be a little too light. I want a lot of variation in blocking and part of this. So that's why I'm doing so much of it. And of course, I do want to cover the entire canvas. Bring some orange back in because some of that yellow dulled it a little bit. It's more prominent around the edges. I don't even know if I can read that. The Finchum Radial Rectifier and Plotter? Patent pending? This might actually need just a little bit of, that's a shadow. There are some deep shadows in here, so I'm going to take a little bit of this orange, I'm going to add a tiny bit of magenta to it. Right, there's some down here. Wherever you want. As soon as I'm allowed to have a merch shelf. I'm going to need to plot out this tree here. Before I go any further. Hmm. While I have it here, there isn't a branch there, but since I have the graphite line, do you hear this? I can never hear Lisa's frogs. But I think everyone can hear that. Okay. Give that a second to dry and deal with the cat. He's in my room now, so hopefully that'll be better. Okay. Now that I know where my tree is basically going to be, I can go back to finishing off this tree. You absolutely do need a Valentine's zombie snail. Of course you do. What would you do without a Valentine's zombie snail? I think some of this orange is a little too harsh, so I'm just toning it down a little with the yellow. I know. I know that this goes a little bit deeper up here. Gotta get this in here. Needs a little brown. Just scruffy painting. I agree. Shana. I agree so much. It's so much more enjoyable sometimes to just watch other people paint. I think I spent a little too much time doing that though. So that's why I've started doing this. Because if you're not making your own work, hello, Karen. Hello, DJ. Thank you for joining. Thank you. Excuse me. Cool, cool, cool. Okay. Now, going back into some of this green. My brown has dried. There wasn't much left anyway. And again, I'm just blocking in. There is no detail yet. No need for detail yet. Yeah, the kitty's being a little annoying because he really wants to go outside because he's an indoor-outdoor cat. And there's 9 inches. At least that's what my kitties do. Just trying to get all the coverage I need. I'm still letting some of that orange that I had mixed up mix into the green. I'm barely using any brown. I'm just letting the orange and the green become brown as I go. And if I don't like the coverage in an area, I just go back over it. There are no mistakes. This whole section over here to be a little darker. So I'm going over with just some pure green, which is blending into the brown. Don't like that brush stroke. Getting rid of that. Okay. I'd say we're almost there. Almost done blocking in. More of that purplish color. Not a lot, though. Just a tiny bit. Probably going to be a little too dark, but it's okay. No, that's good. And it probably does, but I'm going to put a little bit right here anyway. There will be some blue going over that, so. Nah. This is just a little indication of shadows I'm trying to get in here on some of these underwater rocks. And they definitely get fainter as they go because the water is getting deeper. So what I'm doing is I'll load it up. I'll load up the brush and just, let it run out of paint as I go further back. How's that looking? Looking good? Okay. Okay, got the log based in. Now we got some ground over here. It's gonna have to be blocked in. Go ahead, Nick. He's more important. Our animals come first? More paint. Well, I'm not going for perfection. I am trying at least get some of the shape blocked in. When I went through here with the pencil, I left a couple of specific circular type rock shapes. And if you go around them, let them dry a tiny little bit, and then come back. The brush strokes will actually give you your pencil line back in a way. Not completely, but you know where stuff is. I can still see those lines. I don't know if you can. Thank you. This is a little difficult because my drawing table stops right here and the canvas starts right here. So. Just trying to make an indication of where these rocks are out in the water. Okay. Almost there. Here, one that comes down in here. Okay. There's one little spot over here where I didn't do anything, but that's almost a pure sky blue, so I'm going to leave that there for next time. And I think we're blocked in. That's a good start. I have no idea what time it is. It's 4:25. Okay. A little shorter than I expected, but hey. Getting done faster is not always a bad thing. You know, when in the beginning I said, you know, you got to paint what you see, not what you think you see. And that's sort of, you're engineering the invisible. You're painting the illusion of reality. And hopefully, I did a little bit to explain that. So, hopefully, this will dry and we'll come back to it next week and we'll do some interesting things. Give it a little bit more depth, finish some things off, and yeah, that's it. That's where I'm going to call it. Thank you all for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope maybe you learned something. If not, let me know in the comments. Do the liking, the subscribing, the sharing, that stuff. Hit the buttons, do the things. Social media, you know. And I'll see you next time. So long.